Everyone, welcome back to Shadesztown. Pretty excited about this episode, actually. Been doing a whole lot of off-camera work, both me and my wife. My wife's been terraforming that desert, flattening it down. And I have been working over here, building that big thing. That's huge. Right now it's pretty plain. We will make it look better in due time, but for right now, that's okay. For this episode, I want to start on the guts of that. So, as you can see, our witch farm's going. Working pretty well, actually. And, I haven't sat AFK, but obviously as I've been working on this, it's built up some stuff. Let me show you. So, inside here, this is going to be our chemical plant, aka brewing station. It's not a brewing station. It's gonna be an entire brewing system. Some pretty big plans in here. But anyways, we've got all the stuff in this chest built up just from working, and then that's actually the second chest. The first chest filled up, so I added that on. The first chest is right in here. So, and then I just, you know, link it with a couple of hoppers. So pretty cool, but look at that. That is beautiful. I love it. Okay, so for the start of this episode, I'm not sure how far we're going to go, but I want to build the standing room, quote-unquote observation area, to finish up the witch farm. With that, basically the witch farm will be done, and then we will start working on this chemical plant. And I want the observation area to be up there, and I haven't quite decided how I want to get there, but I think I'm going to use the same style as the stairway up there, which is just the let's go right here, just the stair that you have to jump up off of the wall like that. Oh, that's not what I want. And I don't want mobs to be able to spawn, so I'll put them on the bottom. Like that, right there. Now that is what I want, but that gets up there a little too quick. I want to put a platform here and then go up. So let's start right here and see where that takes us. If we follow that, we get to about right there. Yeah, let's try that. I might end up moving this, but for now, we'll go with it. Give me feedback on that last episode. I did it all sped up. I kind of said I was going to try that out. On the forums, I didn't get very good feedback. People didn't like it. So let me know if you did. I might not do it that way. You know what? I want to back that up a little. I probably won't do it that way unless you guys say you want it that way, where I kind of just speed up the boring stuff. Or if you want me to just skip it, kind of like I did this episode where I did all that and just skipped the work, I can do that too, just whichever you prefer. Let's go one more high. And how do I want to do this? Okay, let's take a look at that. Oh yeah, let's clean this up. Actually, let's jump up there. As you see, there's quite a bit of lag on this server. I used an old laptop for the server, and yeah, that's obviously not gonna work. I used an old laptop for the server, and it's starting to go kerplunk on me. So, we just ordered my wife a new computer anyway, so I'll be using her old computer, which is much better than the laptop, so we'll be back in shape without this lag here in a week or two. Okay, let's see how we look. Probably should throw some light up there. I don't have any torches. Looks kind of small. Don't like it. We need to make that platform bigger. And, oh, I do have enough wool. Okay. Let's pull that out. Let's go grab some torches while we're down here too. Hopefully I've got some in these chests. I really need to clean this stuff up. But it's kind of hard because I dived into building without making a real home or real storage system or anything. So we have the one that's clear over there, but I don't like running back and forth just for stuff. Okay, I'll be back. I gotta go get some torches made. Oh, while I ran to get torches, I crossed my wife's horse. It's a pretty good horse. It actually jumps. Oops, if I can do it right. It's got a 3-high jump. Not the fastest. I mean, it's decent, average, but I love the jump. So we probably will be using that one to... breed up some horses eventually. If we can get him to live that long. Okay, so I want torches. Does she have some? Nope. Do we have a coal? We do have coal. No coal in it, of course. Not that lucky, huh? Oh, can't open that one. Okay, do we have any wood? We do have wood. Okay, let's make some charcoal. Take you. And plump you in there. Okay, that's good enough. It's been a long time since I've made charcoal, and I didn't realize they changed the icon. It looks good. I like it. Help you separate the two, too. Very nice. Okay, let's head on back. As you can see, this is kind of where my wife is terraforming this desert down. So this desert is going to be more of the farmland that we've started over there. Let's jump on this guy. Yeah, I just love his jump. Drop you in there. Head back on over. Okay. And of course we got monsters up there. Alright. Are you gonna come down? You are. Wow, see that lag? That's gonna be a problem. Let's see if I can fix it. 1 second. Much better. Okay. Okay. Oh, creeper. Get away. Don't blow up. Thank you. Wow. He must have fallen from... I don't know. Okay, let's throw some temporary light. Get some light in this situation. Okay. We want that, definitely want that to be bigger. Let's make that bigger. Let's go two this way. Actually, let's go four. See what that looks like. Hey, mister. Grab our XP. Okay. Hi, creeper. Spider. I don't like it. But I was thinking of putting... Whoa, buddy! You found me. I thought I was... Darn it. I thought I was far enough away. Okay. Let's go back to what we were doing. I do want to put kind of a gate around it, or like railing. There you go. So, I was thinking iron bars would look good in this plant. And I thought I stuffed some iron bars around here, but there we go. Let's go take a peek at our witches again. Hi, guys. That lag. Man, I need a new server computer. That's so sad. I'm the only one on, too. Huh. You back. Okay, let's throw those rails up there and see what that does. Start it right there, I think. Yep. Wow, he was booking it. I'm gonna run out of sword. Oh well. We'll make a new one. That's better. Better. Still not 100% though. Well, maybe. You'll probably see that change a little bit, but we'll go with it for now. I don't like the way those join either. Right there. Let's go like that. Oh, maybe that's what it's lacking. What if we did this? Whoop, didn't mean to fall down. Can you get it? Not quite. Okay, let's check that. That looks better. Yeah. Don't mind, it's alright. Kind of don't like that one right there. But that's okay for now. Do I want to go out one more? Should we try? Yeah, let's try. Ultimately, I don't want to use torches in here. We'll see if I can pull it off without torches, but just with the more modern style I want to go with, torches definitely don't work with that. Oop. Oop. Did it again. Okay, not bad. Makes it a little more pronounced. I actually don't mind the torches there. Even them out. Okay, I'm gonna run that guy up. I will be right back. Okay, let's take a look. Yeah, looking good. Okay. I can go with that. I can live with that for sure. Okay, so now for the observation area, I was thinking obviously that I want to stare at that tower, or at least be able to, so cut a big window into the side. And for the window, I think I'll border it with the gray wool, and then obviously put the window in, and I think I'll go flush with the white. You really don't need the offset like I have here clear up there, because you're never going to be so close that you notice the texture to it, or the what's a good word, the dynamic aspect of it. So let's jump up here and cut in our window. I'm not exactly sure how this is gonna end up. I'm kinda thinking, you know, you'd come up to the platform, but then it can wrap around that way, and the window would be somewhere like here. Let's see how high we are. Yeah, that's a perfect height. You got two. If I put a gray one here, then a space of two and a gray one. So we actually would make it, let's see, something like, All right, lag, you gotta work with me. Thank you. Okay, let me go see if I can fix this laptop real quick. I will be back. Okay, I think we that should do it. There we go. It was actually a cooling problem on the laptop. One of the fans has gone out, so the laptop is now sitting upside down, and I have just a room fan blowing over it. It's an old laptop, not worth replacing anything. Can't find that old of a fan for that laptop anyway, so not a biggie. Not a biggie. So let's see. Let's dig this all the way out. This way. I was thinking a big old window. In fact, I'm thinking I want it a little taller too. I think it's going to be a bit narrow. But we'll dig it out and see. Let's go take a look outside. I might change that platform from gray wool to clay. We'll see. I don't have much clay right now. Kind of waiting for the 1.7. Yeah, that definitely needs to be bigger. Taller, anyway. Okay, in fact, I probably want it to be twice as tall. What I was going to say, I'm kind of waiting for the 1.7 to explore more area. I don't want to generate much in this world without the new biomes. Now, I do have a big concern. Let me show you real quick. There's currently a bug. It's reported. Mojang knows about it. But I will lose this witch farm in the 1.7 update. When I upgrade to the update. But I really don't want to lose that. So hopefully they can get it fixed. I'm gonna kind of hold off as long as I can until I can see if they've fixed it. But if they can't, man, I don't know. I know it's a vanilla thing, but I might get some MC Edit going and get it fixed so that the witch farm still works there. It's just too good to. Let's go one more. Yeah. It's just too important for my technical builds and stuff. I need that redstone. I need that witch farm. So we'll see. For right now, we'll just kind of let it run, do its thing, build up some inventory, and keep working on this guy. Was kind of hoping you'd look down at it a little more. This building isn't tall enough for that. Well, let's go look. In fact, let's just take a shortcut. Let's see how it looks from out here. Replace that guy. I wonder if that's backing up. Oh, no, it just stopped. Okay, so that's a good speed. I have it so it doesn't dump out real quick like I had before. I kind of have it spurting out every now and then. I don't know why, just keep it more even. Okay, that window does look better. It's a bit long. But I think we will go with it. I think it'll look better when I put the glass in too. And the glass I have in there, that's right. You probably want that one. You've noticed by now, I'm sure, that I haven't finished the building this way. The main reason for that is I don't know how much room I really need. My torches. Oh, that water got rid of my torches. Darn. But for this chemical system, it's gonna need quite a bit of space. And so what I was thinking is I'm gonna expose as much redstone as I can in here. And I'm gonna use, for like pulse shorteners, I'll use pistons. For timers, I'll use piston timers instead of hopper timers. They would be hopper timers anyway, like on my spider string farm down there, but they'll have pistons instead, that kind of stuff. So a lot of movement, a lot of the redstone I want you to see. I'm going to use mine carts, and I just really want that to be like, hey, this is a technical building that's making pharmaceuticals, so to speak, chemicals. So going to be pretty cool, but I'm thinking that I'm going to encase a lot of it in glass, so you can come and watch it, but give you the feeling that it's fully automated, that it's in a clean room, that kind of stuff. Should be pretty cool. But anyways, I don't know how much space I need, so I'm leaving it open. It's just a lot of work to do. If I need to shrink it or make it bigger, that'd be a lot of wasted time. So there we go, creepers are gone. But should be pretty cool. I'm really excited about this build in here that we'll start next episode. Oh, they weren't gone. Well, these guys weren't. Okay, creeper, get away. Don't blow up. Thank you. Die. Thank you. Ah, and another one. Get out of here. I need a sword, I'm wasting my diamond. Nah, darn it. Yeah, while I'm down here, let's plug this. Let's just use stone since we got it. I don't want to hear that water running the whole time. There we go. Okay. I hear more monsters. Okay. Where did that creeper come from? Did he come from out here? Maybe? No. Don't know. Let's add some light though, just make us feel better. Okay, let's add backup. Hopefully no more mobs are up here. Okay, we're good. Let's throw a torch. Thought you could put them up there, but I guess not. Okay, let's count how many we have over here. And we have, looks like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. What about over here? Let's get a little closer. Whoops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I actually like, I thought this window was a bit too long. So let's do 9 and then gray. There's 9. And then our gray will, whoops. Okay. Seven, eight, nine, and then gray, 8, 9, and then gray. Looking good. And how do you make plan? Oh, like fences. Okay. I'll be back. I should have done that earlier. Where you at, zombie? I hear ya. You in here? You're out there? No. Oh, you are. Mm. Wife's texting me, let's see. She wants to see, wants me to text her the pictures. My poor niece, she got bit by a shark. She was, my brother took his family down to the Bahamas, and they were feeding the fish, snorkeling with the company, and they were feeding the fish, and they had a bag of fish food, and I guess it had opened or something, and the fish started swarming around them real heavy. Well, they had seen a shark, you know, they had taken pictures of it, pretty cool. It's like a 5-foot long reef shark. And, well, it decided it was hungry, it seems like. So it was kind of down below them and suddenly started bolting like straight up towards the school of fish. And the fish obviously darted away, but my poor niece, she's 8 years old. She was in the school fish, and it bit her on the leg pretty good. Luckily, no. So my brother saw it kind of happening, and the hero that he is, I mean, he kind of prepped himself. He was swimming over to her to try to save the situation. And on the way over, he was thinking, okay, how am I going to get her out of the water? How am I going to stop the bleeding? Just basically mentally preparing. And both him and my nephew, from what it sounds like, saw the shark bite her on the leg. And she let out a scream, obviously, a loud, blood-curdling scream. And luckily, the shark let go. And my brother was there, right there, ready to punch it or something, trying to, you know, get it off of her, but it had let go and was swimming away, so he grabbed her and threw her into the boat, and then jumped in the boat. Her mom was in there, and so they were in there. Her mom held her, and he started, you know, he compressed the wound right away, and then the staff on the boat, you know, brought over first aid kits and stuff, but she's okay. She, it took out a pretty good 3-inch gash on the back of her leg. And then on the front, you can see the individual teeth marks. Pretty gnarly pictures, but obviously I'm not going to post those. Let them have their privacy. But they called a speedboat. The snorkeling company called a speedboat and had the speedboat meet them out there. And then they sped her up to... How do I want to do this right here? Sorry, I got to think a minute. Ah, I like this. Should we come out one more and go this way? Actually, I don't like that. Let's take off this row right here. So I was saying they called that speedboat. And, you know, it sped her onto shore with her parents. My nephew was still on the snorkeling boat. But got him to shore, and by that time the owner was there. And he was pretty upset. It'd been 35 years he's been in business. And, you know, and it's a legitimate big company from what it sounds like, snorkeling company. It's not just you go find someone on the shore and say, hey, take me snorkeling. So he was pretty upset from what I hear, pretty concerned. And he said, you know, we could have called the ambulance, but it would have taken an hour for it to get here, which obviously is a no-go. So they put her in the back of his truck and drove her to a local medical center, which wasn't an actual hospital from what it sounds like, and they said, you know, we really just aren't equipped. We don't have the resources to take care of her here, give her the care she needs. So they put her in an ambulance and drove her across the island, and let's see, should I go out a couple more? Yeah, let's do. And so they drove her across the island to the hospital. And they had taken a couple pictures of her leg as they were wrapping it on the boat, and they showed that to the surgeon, and, you know, he said, oh, it'd be about an hour to stitch everything up. Well, I don't know on this part. It was either 2 hours or 8 hours later. He comes out and he says, well, she's okay. You know, surgery went well, but It took a lot more. It was a lot worse than we thought. And I don't like how wide that is. We're going to shrink it back down. But he says it was a lot worse than the pictures looked like. So it took a lot longer. And my brother asked something about, well, was it? And he goes, it was a lot of stitching. And that's what took for a while or something like that. Anyways, and my brother said, so how many stitches? Like 100. And the surgeon goes, no, hundreds of stitches. Yeah, the poor thing. 8 years old. It's like 1 in 11 million chance, and she got bit by a shark. But the gash, you know, it ripped the skin off. It ripped... Some of you might not want to know this. Anyways, it didn't damage any muscle. It got the fatty tissue, got the skin, but it didn't get down to the muscle. No nerve damage, from what it sounds like. So she's lucky. They're lucky. And luckily, my brother had the presence of mind to handle it right away and, you know, kind of take care of business as soon as he got there, which, you know, props to him for doing that. She, within 3 days, I think it was, she was walking on it, again, limping, you know, kind of obviously giving it a little thing. But the stitches, so I just saw a picture of the stitches. And it didn't look like they had to stretch much skin over that gash, which I really thought they would. So she'll obviously have some scarring. She saw a plastic surgeon, but I don't know if they're going to do much with that. But the snorkeling company, the guy, they got to the hospital, and it was a private hospital. They said, you know, you got to prepay. And the snorkeling company's like, the guy that owned it, he said, well, if I could talk, you know, I'm paying for it. So I'll take, too focused on the story. So, you know, he kind of fronted that money right then, which is nice. Let's see. I like it. Got a nice little platform. Can still look out at the farm area, those chemical plant. Then you can come around here. I don't like that gap. I really don't like that gap. How am I going to fill that in? Trying to think. What if I... Whoops. That was fail. You know what? We might just do this whole thing right here in glass. Kind of wrap it around, at least so you can jump in, like, say, right there. Let's try that. Yeah, that looks real modern, actually. Do I want glass on the rest of that? No. I already have a lot of glass out there. I don't want too much glass around this place. Especially if I do the glass window, that'll be too much. So we'll keep the iron bars. But yeah. So, we're lucky. They're lucky. I'm just glad that it turned out okay. So I like this. You come out, you can watch. It's daytime, so it's lit up, but I'm gonna want to light it. And how do I want to light it? Actually, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're 7 away. So if I put a... if I put redstone lamps up there, I think we can light it down here enough to not have mobs spawn at night. So we will put a lighting system up here too, which should be pretty cool. But yeah, I'm pleased. The height's okay. You can look down. Move over to the side so you can kind of see all four if you want. God, look at them all fall. I love it. Looks like they were jammed up there. Somehow. Anyways, let's jump down and see how it looks down here and then run out and see how it looks outside. So, moral of the story is... Don't trust a shark. Just kidding. Be ready for accidents and bad situations. We can make that bigger. I wanted to make it bigger, but I thought it'd look tacky down here, but it actually looks kind of skinny. And we have blocks. Yeah, so be ready. Like I said, my brother was ready to pull her out of the water so she wouldn't bleed in the water, and then jump in the boat and press those wounds just real quick. So props to him. Let's see. Let's take this out, make this. Should I make it one or two bigger? Let's try. I'm thinking two. I want this to be kind of a cool platform. And once I'm done with this platform, we're going to call it the end of this episode and the end of the witch farm section. Because the witch farm is fully operational. And so you'll just come up here and stand, go AFK, so I definitely need to make sure we have light here. I guess you'd be within 16 blocks, so no monsters would spawn. But just to not risk it, we need to light this place up. But the witch farm is done. That project was pretty big. Not as big as this thing's gonna be. And I'm trying to decide. I know, like, a lot of YouTubers don't like showing the redstone work because I guess it gets kind of boring for the viewer. But I started this channel with the intention of actually doing a Let's Play, but more not tutorial style, but as people watch the Let's Play, they get familiar with the redstone. It's really hard to do because redstone takes a lot of, you know, put this here, oh, it doesn't work, move it. Try this way, oh, it doesn't work, change it. So there'd be, you know, a lot of editing, take quite a bit of work, but I still think I might do it because it kind of just goes with the flavor of the server that I want. Which, if I do, there's going to be quite a few episodes as I build this brewing system here. But the platform looks good up here. In fact, it still looks a little thin. Let's go down here and see. I like those stairs. They turned out good. Yeah, that platform is plenty big. Okay. Yeah, that adds some character in here. I like it. Need to get some lighting set up in the down here, but all in due time. So, like I said, we will call that one an episode, and that is the end of the witch farm. Let me jump up here and leave you with a view of the witches. But once again, guys, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. If you liked, you know, the witch farm, if you like what's going on here, give me a like. Also, give me feedback on that episode before this. I think it was episode 24. If you like that sped up style, let me know. Like the video and let me know. I might do more. If you don't like it, give it a dislike, and I will not do those again. So, but I really appreciate it. We'll let that section right there, we'll let those guys fall and call that the end of the video. So, thanks for watching, guys, and as always, happy building.